It's April Fool's Day, which means I get a free pass to trick all of you into thinking I'm making drastic changes to my channel. One moment. GPUs are just too expensive, guys, so I've decided to give up on PC gaming entirely so I can focus on my hoes, rakes, and other agricultural implements. That's right, I'm a farmer now, and I plan to till this soil until it bears fruit, which I will feast upon most sensually. Prepare yourselves, because we're going right through the back door on this episode of Paul's Hardware.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise, tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. So last time I did an update on my backyard was about 8 months ago in July 2024 when we got a tractor to do some grading and soil removal. That was a pretty big job, but we got through it and then we got started on some of the fundamentals for irrigation, and we also primed and painted this back wall back here, which used to be a salmon pinkish color. Between then and now, there have been occasional random work days that have happened on weekends. That's typically when my sister Gretchen and brother-in-law Alex have been available to come help out, because they have been spearheading and directing a lot of the work that's been done back here because they have a lot of prior experience with this type of thing. So for today's recap, the work was pretty much split into two phases. One was adding the mulch or the compost or the mulch compost to the area that we had graded, and then pretty much finishing off the irrigation so we could have watering set up for plants and things that we're trying to grow back here intentionally versus the weeds that grew before. And a bit of a spoiler, but things are functional and I can now control my sprinklers with my phone. Ah, see? There they go. So jumping back to July, when work continued, we were getting ready for the compost, and before that got delivered, we had to set out some bender boards so we could establish certain areas in the backyard as well as put down a path. So we spent a couple days laying down that bender board, getting it secured with plastic and metal stakes, and we also drilled it into the side of the concrete patio and the wall back there where it met up with that. Then at the end of August, we had a mulch delivery via a double dump truck full of it and a very experienced and awesome driver who was able to back up onto my side yard in order to dump both loads. He was definitely a pro with the dump truck maneuvering that got the mulch a lot closer to our work areas, so that saved us a lot of time and earned him a nice tip. And then we had a couple days where I had the whole family come over to help distribute that mulch across the yard using rakes, wheelbarrows, and shovels.
Here's a little backyard status update. The first day that we worked on this project in earnest was the last weekend in June. It is now the last weekend in August. We have put, I'm gonna say, another 2-3 days worth of work into this yard sporadically here and there, just to figure some stuff out, get this bender board in place where we want it to be in order to lay out the area for our path. We've started to put down some weed guard underneath some of that. We started laying a little bit of the rock material. You can see the swales here because we're in California. We don't want the water to run off and away from our property. We actually want to capture it. So these swales are low areas where the water is going to be draining down to so it can actually seep into the ground. We also made some progress with the irrigation. We got some sprinklers going, the line that we ran over to that side so we can have spigot for our hose, as well as an outdoor like garden sink. It's gonna be right over here, a little storage shed as well. But the cool thing is this is actually functional now. So there is a sprinkler head over here, one more over here, and those have been going just like every 2-3 days, just to sort of start to temper the soil a little bit, because that's really our issue, is that the soil we have here is very dry, not a lot of living things in the soil, very dry and not very like good soil for growing stuff. So our plan today is to fix that a little bit. And so just yesterday we had 2 big truckloads full of this dumped off here. This is actually all plant material. It is, I don't know if I can officially call this mulch or not, but we're gonna be spreading this in various areas across the yard today. And for that, we've called in some help.
We had a lot of mulch. There were some areas where we just did basic cover with maybe 3 or 4 inches. And then there were some areas where we built it up a bit more to provide some contour for the yard according to the plans. Also at that time, we established the area over on this side, which is separated by bender board. This is gonna have Kurapia for ground cover, which has already started to grow and is expanding thanks to it being springtime now.
It's kind of crazy how work like this feels like you're taking so much time, but we actually only worked for about 2 hours. Made a lot of progress though.
Thanks, of course, to multiple wheelbarrows, we have taken this pile down a lot, starting to cover a bit of that area over there. We finished off that far section. The reason there's bender board between those is we're going to have Kurapia ground growth growing on this side, and we don't want it to be able to come over into this side. But we have filled in right about up to here. I'd say we're halfway done, maybe even a little bit more than halfway. And where'd everybody go? Oh yeah, it's lunchtime. Pretty much done with work for today. We've got lots of ground cover put in. Is it mulch or is it compost? This is actually plant compost, which is a type of mulch. So in case anyone was very curious about that. And we have all these fig beetles now that are really, really enjoying our area. This area over here is gonna be covered with Kurapia. We don't wanna pay a bunch of money for plants because plants can be really expensive. So my sister brought this Kurapia from her house, a bunch of clippings. We're gonna lay that down, distribute it, cover it with a little bit more mulch so it doesn't dry out, and then hopefully some of those will take root and we'll start to get some ground cover right here.
We don't have any dogs at the moment, but in the future this will be the area where the dogs do their business, and Kurapia is very resistant to drought, and it also doesn't really require mowing or anything like that. You just gotta kinda take care of it along the edges where it starts to creep. When we had set up the initial irrigation, this area was set to be watered on a regular basis so the soil could start to get moist and prepare for the Kurapia. And after that, it was controlled by this fairly basic inline controller, which has a battery operation. But as you can tell, we've moved on from that. Also, my mom and my wife spent a lot of time distributing some Kurapia clippings in this area to try to get some to take root, but it was late summer and it was pretty hot, so we're not sure all of those survived. But my sister and brother-in-law came in later with some actual planters and we distributed a few of those, which have done well and again are starting to spread, so eventually this whole area will be covered. Also at that time, my sister found some really inexpensive sage plants for like $1.50 each, and those have been added along the top wall back there. Fast forwarding again to after the holidays and 2025, when we started more seriously on the irrigation work. My brother-in-law Alex reached out to some of his industry connections, pulled some strings, called in a favor, and got Hunter to agree to send us over some hardware to use for the irrigation. So a big thank you to Hunter for sending over their Pro HC Wi-Fi irrigation controller with touchscreen, as well as the HC flow meter and the Node BT, which is a Bluetooth controllable unit, which is actually what's controlling the Kurapia area sprinklers here in the backyard, since that's not integrated with the rest of the sprinkler system quite yet. You also might notice trees. We have trees now. That's a small growing apple tree over there, which has some beautiful blossoms. We have a spicy nectar plum, which is a hybrid, and we've got a couple miniature pear trees over on the other side. Those are planted by my sister and my wife back in January. I didn't get footage of that, but I did get footage of laying down the drip line, and that is what is going to be watering most of the area back here. It's flexible tubing, which is very lightweight and easy to sort of lay around where you need it to go, and then you can also move it over time if needed, which we are going to be doing for certain things like the trees, which you want to water in a zone, like a circular zone around it to encourage the spreading of the roots. Once the drip line is laid out, you can just punch in some leads that come off of it, and then you have these little dribbler sprinklers that are adjustable that you can position exactly where you want to, and again you can relocate those over time as needed.
It's a drip line irrigation around the trees, and then these little dogs here getting in my way. A little spaghetti string going up here to actually water the trees, and then as the trees get bigger, those get backed up to encourage root growth.
Yes.
Something like that.
We definitely want root growth.
You want the roots to grow.
Meanwhile, at the front of the house, my brother-in-law Alex was handling the main irrigation area where we have a bunch of valves, and we were replacing all of the old valve units with new valve units. And as part of that valve upgrade, we had to swap out the solenoid from each valve with the solenoids that were provided by Hunter, so we would have solenoids that were compatible with the Hunter irrigation controller. Alex handled the wiring up of all of the valves, connecting it up to the control box, mounting the control box to the side of the house, and then of course you have different valves for different zones that the controller can enable or disable as needed according to how it is programmed. So there was a fair amount of PVC pipe cutting, priming, and gluing to get everything connected up there properly. But thankfully, when all was said and done, we had our Hunter Pro HC controller mounted to the side of the house. We even stole some conduit wrapping from my wall-mounted PC in the garage to sort of tidy that up a little bit. From there, I just followed the instructions that came with the Pro HC controller to get it connected to my house's Wi-Fi. And then I was able to use the Hydrowise app, which is the main app that Hunter uses, to connect to that controller and then set up all of the different zones for watering, which we have 7 of total now, including the front yard and the backyard, although a couple of them aren't currently in use because we have some more planter boxes we want to put over here. And then we're also going to be doing some additional like shrubbery and stuff like that around the edges of this area once the trees have taken root and once we get the DG put in.
Here's how this works. We have 7 different zones. I've set up most of them so far. We add a zone. We choose the zone we want according to where it's connected to the controller, which is zone 1. It's the only one we haven't set up. We were entering a temporary name until we could figure out where each zone was so we could add it and turn it on. So now zone 1 is added. And with the zone added, we can like manually run it, and that way we can tell where the actual zone is controlling. Tell it to run for 2 minutes, and we hit start. Oh, there it goes. Sprinklers pop out and start working. Hey, come back. Oh, there it is. And now we know what area this zone is controlling.
The really cool thing about the Hunter Pro HC controller is that first it allows me to add some tech to this video that would otherwise be about doing work in the backyard. But the HydroWise app actually adds some intelligence to your irrigation because it's going to be monitoring your local weather reports. So it will disable or turn off your irrigation system in certain conditions, like if it's raining or if it has rained recently, or even if the temperature gets too low. There's actually a whole list of those variables that you can enable or disable depending on your preference. The other unit that they gave that's actually connected to the Kurapia area here in the back is called the Hunter Node BT. And that actually uses a separate app and it's Bluetooth controllable just directly with the phone. We had a unique situation with this area back here where it was difficult to have a valve in the front yard control this area, which is why it's separate. So for now we have Bluetooth control for that. And then Hunter told us that they're working on a different control unit that can be operated wirelessly or by battery, but that can still connect to the main controller to have all that intelligence built in too. And that pretty much brings us up to speed for today, although a little bit more time has gone by. So we've had rain and we've had the sprinklers working and we have things growing back here in our backyard, and again, things that we want to have growing back here, not just weeds and stuff. A few other things to round things out and answer some questions. We have low points at a couple areas in the backyard. Those are called swales. They have large rocks in the bottom, and that's for drainage. When we did the grading, we specifically made low points where water from rain, precipitation, when it does happen here in Southern California, will be encouraged to go. And I'm happy to say that those totally work. They did fill up with a little bit of water when we got some heavy rain a month or two ago, but the patio has not been getting any water pooling on it at all anymore. So those swales are pretty swell, is it? Horrible joke I made several times. See that swale? It's pretty swale. That swale is not so swale. We do have some other stuff growing out here though that we've noticed over the past few months. Mushrooms. We've apparently got some mycelium going underneath the compost mulch that we added in. So back at the beginning of winter, we had some mushrooms sprouting up, and now that it's spring again, we have lots of mushrooms springing up. We also have something called slime mold, and this particular type has a great name, dog vomit slime mold, because that's kind of what it looks like. Fortunately, according to my sister, who I'm trusting with her knowledge on this topic, what the mushrooms and slime mold are doing are helping break down the compost, and that makes it a better environment for growing plants there, so we have continued to let them proliferate. And I haven't noticed any cordyceps amongst the mushrooms. We're definitely keeping an eye out for that. Don't want to be ground zero for a last of a situation or anything like that. We also have some weeds trying to break through the mulch barrier that we have laid down, and those are starting from the dirt that's beneath the mulch barrier, so it's hard to pull them up all the way. So we've very cautiously been using Roundup to take care of those when necessary, although we're very careful with that because stop it. Stop it, Roundup. Stop giving me cancer. But that pretty much covers it and brings you guys up to speed. The next step for the backyard project is going to be DG, also known as decomposed granite, which is a powdery-like material. We're gonna have a load of that also dropped off on the side yard, and then we're gonna be distributing it along the paths that we've laid out with the bender board, as well as the fire pit area that's right over there behind me. But that wraps it up for this video, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. April Fools and all. And if you have any comments or feedback for me, leave those in the comment section down below. When I do these types of videos, they typically don't perform quite as well, but I do have a fair amount of people coming and saying that they really like these types of videos. So I'm trying to do them here and there. And I do plan to do another update once we move on to the next step. Thank you guys so much once again for watching the video. I'll post links to those Hunter products that we use down in the video's description, and we'll see you all in the next one.